you got something nice to say about me. I enjoy an accolade like the rest. And you could take my picture and hang it in a gallery of all the who's who's and so-and-so's that used to be the best at such and such. It wouldn't matter.
Folks, this is 52 Uncommon Dates, our first night, and just to kind of give a little intro into why we're doing this, what we're doing, this has nothing to do with me and Vanessa, other than the fact that we're in it. Our hope and our prayer is to encourage other couples to spend time with each other and just kind of break the norm. So many times we get involved in the rat race of work and schedule, and Vanessa and I don't have kids, but for those of you that do have kids, you have a schedule, you have certain things that you do, you have certain places that you go eat, certain places that you go to for entertainment, things that you order, things that you watch on TV. And we're trying to encourage everybody to kind of break the cycle and get out and try some new things and learn, not necessarily learn more about each other, but explore different things about each other and hopefully deepen your relationship. So we came across this book a couple of weeks ago and originally looked at it for a devotion, and in looking into it, kind of quickly realized that it's not going to work for a devotion, but it might work for this. So who knows what this turns into. Our prayer is that God takes this and does with it what he wants to do with it. And we just pray that we are vessels that he can use to serve whatever purpose he wants to in this. So Vanessa's going to kind of go over our first night. We have a little bit of instructions, kind of an intro into the first night. Where we're going and what we're doing is still kind of up in the air. We had a little bit of a misunderstanding with our plans to begin with, so I'm going to concede that to my wife because it's her deal. So, Vanessa?
The title of this chapter is The First Time for Everything Date. Words to grow on. For God has not given us a spirit of fear and timidity, but power, love, and self-discipline. 2 Timothy 1:7. You don't have to have money to keep romance alive in a marriage, but you do have to be thoughtful. Setting the scene. God created us with the capacity to enjoy a wide variety of experiences. Too often, though, we limit ourselves by sticking to what we know. We hang out in the places where we feel most comfortable, with the people that make us feel comfortable. We talk about things we know. We wear a groove in our comfort zone that over time becomes a rut. If that sounds familiar to you, then this is where you reserve the trend and pull out of the rut. On this date, nothing will feel familiar or comfortable because everything you do will be a first. The best way to approach this date is to consider your natural instincts and then do the opposite. Here are some things you'll need to think about. 1, change your venue. Find a nearby town or city that neither of you have ever stepped foot in and start your date there. Expand your palate. What's the most eclectic restaurant in the area. What's the strangest thing on its menu? Start ordering there. From appetizers to desserts, the only rule is don't eat anything that's crossed your palate before. Explore a new form of entertainment. Keep the conversation fresh. If most of your date night conversations involve your job or kids, this is the night to declare those topics off limits. Anything you've ever discussed before, you've never discussed before, is fair game. Take it to God. Before your date, spend some time in prayer together. Thank God for the variety of people and situations He put in your path. Thank Him for His blessings and mercies, which are new every morning. In the spirit of this date theme, ask Him to show you areas of your life in which you are in danger and fallen into a rut, give you the creativity and courage to try new things to escape or avoid a rut, help you keep your relationship fresh and exciting, help you maintain an adventurous spirit in your Christian walk. Dig deep. The Christian life is all about newness and freshness. The Bible tells us that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person, 2 Corinthians 5:17. The last thing a new person needs is to get stuck in an old rut. If you want to be inspired to live more adventurously, check out the following passages. Psalm 92:12-14, Lamentations 3:22-23, Luke 5:36-39, Colossians 3:10.
So the instructions were that we need to pray before we go out on this date to get our mindset and everything right. I'm not going to record that because I'm not a huge fan of making a big production out of prayer. Vanessa and I are going to do that. We're going to do that off camera. And what she read earlier is to give you guys an idea and a little direction. If you want to do something like this on your own in the future, you have some of the same instructions that we do. So we're going to spend some time in prayer right now before we leave to make sure that our hearts and our heads are right going into this. And we'll see you guys at the restaurant. I can edit that out. Okay, so since we had to bail on Sullivan's, we end up in Little Rock, and we are at, where are we at?
Yaya's.
Having, what is this appetizer that we're having? I'll show you a picture in a minute. What is it again?
Bruschetta.
Having bruschetta. Never had bruschetta before, but the waitress explained it so eloquently and so made it sound good, so we're going to try some bruschetta. My drink is Flyway blueberry something or another. I don't know. It's a beer that I've never had before, but it is actually pretty good. If the bruschetta is half as good as this is, then we're in good shape here. Dinner, we each ordered a dinner that we think that we'll like more so than trying something crazy. We went a little crazy with our drinks and with our appetizer. So here is appetizer that we're having. There's, what are these things called?
Baguettes.
Here's some baguettes. That is, I can't get that right. There we go. Goat cheese, creme, something or another. A whole bunch of tomatoes. She can come over here. Not a huge fan of tomatoes, but the lady said that we're supposed to try the tomatoes, that people like the tomatoes. So we're going to try the tomatoes.
Oh, you haven't tried it yet?
I haven't tried anything yet.
What?
I haven't.
I love it.
She likes it. But I think she liked it beforehand.
No, this is, I didn't have it.
You didn't?
Amazing. Now do you see why I kept joking that the cheese, there's like crack in that cheese?
Yeah. I had hummus last time.
Okay, the hummus is really good too. It's just not my personal favorite. Unless I'm doing it with the chicken
beauty. See, I'm going to just a few tomatoes because I'm not a huge tomato fan.
I completely understand.
You need a little, no, hold on.
Where's the green stuff?
You need some basil.
Basil pesto.
Now try it.
I'm not going to promise that you like it because you hate it. I'm totally just standing here watching this, but I just want to see.
It's not terrible.
Okay.
I don't know that it's my favorite thing.
I but like the cheese part of it I can see growing on me.
Yeah.
I don't know that you can, I don't know that you can make tomatoes that I like.
That's okay. Tomatoes aren't for everybody.
No, they are not. They are not.
I don't like tomatoes, but I like them on this.
Mm. I have a lot of people who say that.
Yeah. I'm
well,
not.
I'm glad you don't hate it.
I do not. Okay. I do not.
That's good.
Very good. Thank you. So.
Ow.
What'd you do? You're gonna get to see my wife cry.
No. I bit my cheek again.
She's done that the last 2 days. Cause something wrong with her. She likes biting her teeth. For the rest of the appetizer, I'm gonna have these baguettes.
No, you're gonna put goat cheese on.
No, I'm gonna have some goat cheese. I like the goat cheese. I am not a fan of that mess over there. Baguettes.
You've never liked pesto.
No. What is pesto? The green thing?
The green stuff.
No, I don't like the green thing or the red thing.
Here, put a piece of garlic on your No, don't do that.
Why would I want garlic? Mm. See, the goat cheese is okay. Let's not go crazy with the goat cheese, but that's plenty. Let's not go crazy with it. I don't need a lot. But it's not bad. Goat cheese is not bad. Never had goat cheese before, but goat cheese is not bad. So, we're not also not supposed to talk about anything that we've ever talked about before. We can't talk about work. We can't talk about family. We can't talk about plans, the weekend, anything. So, we have printed off a list of questions and talking points. That kind of gives us some direction here. I'm going to let you take the lead with that because you went through and marked off some of them. So, what's our first talking point?
It says, what is
the... You know you can see half of your face, right?
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Now, see, lean in. There we go.
What is the dumbest thing you've ever cried about?
The dumbest thing I've ever cried about?
I know mine.
I'm not much of a crier.
Good.
Well, right out of the box, first question, you stumped me. Wow.
Well, you're thinking of yours, I'll go with mine.
What, yeah, okay.
I think the dumbest thing that I cried about that I can remember, I mean, because there's probably a lot.
Somebody's gonna think that's cute.
Because I am a crier.
You are.
I've cried about a lot of things. But I think the dumbest thing is probably when we went to Jonesboro and I cried because they told me I accidentally reserved a smoking room. And we had to sleep in that room and I cried.
I don't know if that I would qualify that as dumb. That's on character. When Vanessa gets really mad, she cries. That was hard for me to get early on because I'm a fixer. I like to fix things. So when she's crying, I'm thinking that I either upset her. What do we have here? There we go. Salad. Go safe, salad.
Set it down
there
right
we go.
There for you.
Yummy.
So that is yours. Do you still need... We've got those, but do you want them so I can bring you a whole new roll?
I'm good. They're fine.
You sure?
I can use those.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I can give you a new roll that hasn't sat on the table.
Okay.
I just, a roll like, of what?
I just
know
that,
what we came out with.
Yeah,
the silverware.
Yeah.
She put the forks, on the table.
You were a wonderful waitress. Wonderful waitress. So, Vanessa's a crier. Took some getting used to. When she cries, doesn't always mean that she's upset. Sometimes it means that.
Sometimes it means
I'm pissed off. Leave me alone.
You.
Yeah, that's exactly what it means. I can't answer that. Can we go to the
Thank
next
you.
Question? I can't answer that one. I'm not really a crier. I can't honestly say the last time that I cried over something stupid.
If you could get rid of one disease in the world, what would it be?
Cancer, without a doubt. It's already touched my family. My aunt had cancer, is a cancer survivor. Love you, Dana. Without a doubt. I mean, there's others that are as bad, if not worse, and have probably touched other people that are watching this. But
cancer would be a big one, but the other one for me would be Alzheimer's. It's a hard one to watch somebody deteriorate that was of a sane mind before, and they just kind of lose their ability to.
Do you have Alzheimer's in your family?
Well, Craig's mom and dad both had Alzheimer's. They both had Alzheimer's, and it was really sad watching more how it affected Craig than it affected Harold, because he didn't know who Craig was. I mean, he thought he was among his railroad buddies, but what was really hard was when he got lost driving. And I just had a friend recently whose dad got lost walking. So we're thinking about you, Bethann, and praying for you.
Bethann, that's your friend from California, right?
Not California, Texas.
Texas, okay. San Antonio. Austin lives in that area.
Austin.
You saw her a couple of times before.
Yes,
that you were,
okay. But she's in Austin, yes.
Gotcha.
Okay.
When you read questions, you get completely out of the frame. We're having to make do with this. I forgot to bring something that brings the camera up a little bit.
If you were offered the position of mayor of your city, would you take it?
Absolutely not.
My answer is heck no.
No, not a politician. Not into politics at all. More of an entrepreneur mindset. I love the businesses that we have. There's others that I want to do in due time. I'm not sure I have the right temperament for politics. Where are you going? Oh, okay. But that's just ups and leaves.
Well, it's kind of weird to have so many.
What was your answer to that? I think I answered that more thoroughly than you did.
The answer is absolutely not. And definitely not in Saline County.
No expanding on it, just no. Okay, I'm not sure that you have a temperament. Neither one of us really have a temperament for politics.
No, I know, for sure. I'd tell someone to go take a flying leap.
Yeah. Incompetence and politically correct, we don't do well with that.
Okay.
What else we got?
What song would you sing for your American Idol audition?
What is this red stuff on here? I'm not sure that goes on a Caesar salad. Apparently it does here, but. That's a different Caesar dressing.
Is it not good?
I'm saying it's not good. Just saying it's different.
I guess we should have a regular salad.
What was that last question?
Are you not going to eat any of this?
Yeah, I will. I will.
It's a $5 salad, everybody.
It's a $5 salad. Don't know if it's worth $5, but it's pretty daggum good.
I'm just thinking about
it's a modified movie quote.
I'm just thinking about the resale quote.
Okay. What was the last question?
I'm pretty dramatic, if you don't know that yet.
Quite dramatic.
So,
I'm the only one in the picture. We're just getting closer. I'm still there. That sounds trouble scooting over. We'll get this camera angle right at some point. There we go. Oh, there we go. What was the last question?
What's
I've asked you like three times.
What song would you sing?
Really?
American Idol audition.
Neither one of us are singers, and that's a question that you pick.
Yeah.
All right, you go first with that. This goat thing is really not bad. Goat.
God Bless America? I don't know.
Does that carry some significance for...
Okay.
Let's skip that question. I'd probably go with some 80s hair band song because I can't sing anyway.
Have you ever...
She can't even finish the question.
Have you ever pooped your pants?
See, no.
Not including when you were a baby.
I heard you. Start laughing at this one when you printed it off. Not that I'm aware of. Even during duck season, when I was growing up.
How we doing, guys?
We're good. Can I have another one of these? What are they called?
Flyway? Yep. Yes. You can just say another beer for now. I got you.
Thank you. I'm going to go with no on that because I can't recall one time that I have.
I definitely have not.
Okay. I heard some interviews with some fighters that have, and they're open about it. They will openly talk about having an accident.
What's the worst job you've ever had? You want to split this one? You can have that.
Don't see her just throw crumbs at me. The worst job I ever had. Okay.
My dog's so loud because now there's people like.
It's an easy question to answer. The worst job that I ever had had nothing to do with the job itself. The job itself was a
being a camera guy.
No, I didn't mind that. But there was a time during that same period that I decided that I was tired of taking pictures, that it was taking away too much from my time on the water. And I worked for, the company was called, I don't remember what the company was called. It was based out of Dallas. It was church-based, but what they did was that they helped churches raise funds for growth, for new buildings, for whatever. So I was basically a glorified telemarketer. I don't do that. I don't sell people things that they don't need. I never have been able to do that. Selling stuff, yes.
Get some salad.
Love selling stuff, but it's gonna be something that people need. So
these are roasted.
Cold calling churches to ask them if they need.
Excuse me. For when your steak comes up.
Ah, thank you.
Are we all done with this?
We are.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
The goat cheese was impressive. I did not know how much I would like that, and that was really, really good. Really good.
I told you.
Really good.
You doubted me, see?
I did doubt you. I can't agree with you on the tomatoes, but the goat cheese was very, very good.
The goat cheese was really the only one that I was insistent about.
It was very good. Very good.
Yeah, that stuff is amazing.
Crack.
I told you. It really is. Okay, so your dinner plates are actually ready, so I'm going to go ahead and bring them out
okay.
to you guys.
Okay.
Just because I don't want them to sit, in there. Okay?
Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
So, not a bad job, just not a good fit. I wasn't there long. I don't do cold calling very well.
My worst job.
Face-to-face, but not cold calling. What's your worst job? You're out of the picture.
That's a tie.
Okay.
And it's more in my adult life than when I was in college, but...
Walmart?
Yes. It was terrible.
There's a story behind that.
Being a cashier at Walmart.
When the sponsors went away in 2007, we kind of had to search for what direction that we were going to go now, which led to a stint at Dillard's that let her know that she did not want to do corporate fashion. Also led to an apartment in Dallas that was 618 square foot, 600 and something square foot. God, it was
a one bedroom.
We were there from March through August of 2008.
March,
not long.
April, May, June, July. We made it 5 months.
Not long, but it was miserable. We were, if there's a step below broke, we were there.
Do you want that right in front of you?
Yes, ma'am.
That
looks wonderful.
That looks yummy.
I choose well.
You do, but you need to eat some more of this salad.
That looks good, too.
Honey?
That looks really good.
Do you want any, do either of you want any fresh Parmesan or cracked pepper?
Ooh, Parmesan.
Parmesan?
Parmesan, please.
Parmesan? You got it. I'll be right back.
Thank you. Check your bread. Apparently that you don't get to keep the red. So yeah, that was a rough time. That was a rough time. Broke. Not happy with where we were in life. Come a long way since then, but yeah, I would agree that was a bad time. So steak and corn and peppers, and she has some kind of pasta dish. We're going to pause this and eat dinner, and then we'll come back.
We didn't have time to get back into the questions at the restaurant. We didn't really leave ourselves a whole lot of time with this episode. Being our first oncoming date, we weren't real sure how long to give ourselves for dinner, for questions, for entertainment. So as this thing goes along, you guys just have patience with us, and we'll get some more of this together. We'll take the questions on to our date number two, as long as they go along with date number two. And to be honest with you, the only thing that we've looked at on date number two is kind of the theme and where it has us going. And I don't know how we're gonna pull this one off. This has got us going to a strange location. And that's really all we've looked at into date number two. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Again, Vanessa and I don't want this to be about us. We are sharing this experience with you guys in hopes of being an encouragement to the other couples out there to get out and explore and explore things outside of the norm and get into a deeper relationship, not only with each other, but into a deeper relationship with our Lord and Savior. And if you don't have that, honestly, that's the center point of Vanessa and I's relationship. When things are going well, when our relationship is at its best, God is at the center of that. So our hope and prayer is that this becomes whatever it becomes that God has in mind for it to be, and it means for you guys whatever God has in mind for it to mean to you guys. Thank you for tuning in, and thank you for giving us 30 minutes of your time. Hope you enjoyed this, and we'll see you guys next week.